I appreciate this place. I appreciate Pat. This song is
I was a young heroes camper. I guess I met Pat when I was maybe 11 or 12, in that range. He took me in like a son. I'm not who I am standing in front of you today without Heroes Camp. You got to have them on your prayer list. I'm not sure if any of you all understand what that takes to always be giving, always extending, always answering phone calls. Who's at the door? Was when you coined the term booger love. Y'all can ask Pat about what's booger love. I'll let y'all think about it. You know, you can't get it off you all the time. You can't shake it, right? That was something that stuck with him through the years, man, and it's something that you've remained true to the day. God bless Heroes Camp.
And I was a first generation Heroes camper back 12, 13 years old. I remember coming in first generation. There was, you know, maybe 20, 30 kids. They just kept building and growing. And being a young kid, I was there because I wanted to play basketball or lift weights or hang out or whatever. But a funny thing happened coming week after week after week. You know, I started to really have those seeds of not just understanding what my Christianity was, but wanting to make sure that that was something that I expressed to everybody I come into contact with in my life. And I remember him talking about this vision he had, this vision where there was going to be this massive rec center, and we're going to have food there for people, and we're going to have, you know, places to get your hair cut, and we're going to have basketball, it's going to be running, and we're going to get people all over. We're fighting for educational justice in Chicago. We have 17,000 homeless kids who are enrolled in Chicago public schools right now. 17,000. And I was telling Pat, well, when we were out there, we're on the picket lines walking downtown yesterday. I'm like, how as a teacher, how am I supposed to give kids homework when they don't have a home to go to? And that desire and that quest for justice and righteousness, and they're intertwined, they go together, and that started at Heroes Camp for me. And one of the greatest gifts that Pat and BJ gave to me was consistency. And I said that when I grow up, I'll be just like that.
I known Pat and BJ from birth. I went to Pat actually. You know, why do you let them keep coming around? And Pat said, I don't love them, then who will? And that stuck with me. And what Heroes Camp means and what it stands for is getting down to a basic foundation. A basic foundation of what Jesus taught us is to love the least of us, work with the kids. One day, we're out, my wife and I, on the islands. There was a group of kids there, weren't in school, weren't doing anything, and all I had was a ball, and we went out there for 3 hours, played with these kids on the island, and my wife took a picture, and she posted, like, Jeff had his own Heroes Camp today.
They're great. This ministry is great. It's changed a lot of people's lives. These two guys are products of the camp. They now have kids that are now products of the camp. It's becoming a generational group of people and young people. Men being able to be invested in and become a thriving part of our society.
Thank you, man of God. Thank you, Mama BJ, and thank everybody for allowing Heroes Camp to be the only thing of its nature in our region, in our state.
But he knows the problems that go on. They understand the issues that go on with these children because they love them, because they pray for them.
This is an impossible dream without Christ in the center.